Let us see another way of pass by reference. Here again we are sending the array by using pass by reference, but this time we are sending entire array to the function. So by sending the base address, we know that name of the array is the base address. So by sending base address to the function, we are sending entire array to the function show. Okay, here I have written 5 to denote number of elements. Okay, now this address of Sam, I mean base address of Sam, is received in K. It's a pointer variable. So we have stored the base address of the array in the pointer variable K, and number of rows, that is 5, we have stored in a integer type of data, that is P. Okay, now see next point. Now how to display the contents of this array? Here in the for loop, the value of I is from 1 to P. So first element to the last element, you see here as instead of 0 I have taken 1, and here instead of less than sign I have taken less than or equal to sign, that is why it is 1 to 5. Okay, and now in printf function I am displaying star k. K is pointing to the base address of the array, and star k means the value of the element to whom k is pointing. Okay, after that you increment the k. We know that the property of the pointer, that if you increment the pointer, then it will point to the next location of its type, and hence after incrementing this value, it will point to the next element of the array, and so that we can display the content of the array. Let us execute this program and see the output of dos prompt. Yes, the for loop has displayed all the elements of the array. Is it clear? Thank you.